Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I thank the Honourable Member for asking a very, very interesting question. Even before I rose to answer the question, the interest generated in mosquitoes actually was there. So once again, thank you very much. And mosquitoes don't choose people who they bite, Honourable Gavoka. They don't. Nor do fleas. Nor are they favourable to any geographic location where they breed. Okay? So it could be in Singatoka, Nandronga. It could come to Ba. It could be anywhere. Okay. Thank you very much. Madam Speaker, in response to Honourable Chan's question, chemical spraying is not the answer to dengue or mosquito control. The basic and primary solution is to destroy the breeding grounds, and that is what we are promoting, and to keep environmental clean, and again, that's what we are promoting. Madam Speaker, we need to change our attitudes, and we need to exercise greater responsibilities in taking care of our environment and destroying every place where the dengue-causing mosquitoes could breed. However, Honourable Chan, spraying, perifocal spraying has been ongoing since last November with the conjunction with the municipal councils. The town councils look after their own boundaries. The rural authorities' boundaries come under the Ministry of Health. But again, in partnership with the local councils, we have had spraying ongoing. Like I said, since last November, areas where we found that dengue-causing mosquitoes were breeding, we have been spraying that, and again, it's still continuing. Like I said, while spraying chemical has its uses, but it is only useful in the short term because it largely kills adult mosquitoes, as well as many other useful insects that are within our environment, and not the larva or the baby mosquitoes, which normally breed in stagnant water collected, I'm sure you all know, in empty tins, tires, flower vases, clogged drains and gutters. And I've been told that even a small spoonful of water, stagnant water, is enough to be a breeding grounds for dengue-causing mosquitoes, including unkept garages, unkept industrial areas. Yes, it could include bus bays, etc.
Garage,
or any place where there's overgrown grasses. It's just for the information of the House, Madam Speaker, when this issue was brought up on Monday about Lambasa Hospital having more dengue than outside, I actually got photos sent to me from people in Lambasa saying that there's certain bus company garages that need to clean their garages first before talking about that. I'm not going to name that, Madam Speaker. So, Madam Speaker, we believe that spraying chemicals in the environment should be used with caution and in moderation, as it also leads to mosquito building resistance against the effects of chemicals. And of course, it can pose to have some degree of negative impact on our environmental health. For the information of the House, Madam Speaker, in Fiji we have close to 26 types of mosquitoes, 26, and out of that, there's only two. Aedes aegypti and Aedes albopictus. Those are the two that cause dengue. The rest of them are nuisance mosquitoes, so they would come and bite you, whether it's in the hospital or whether it's your home, whether it's a bus or a car or a public place, but only dengue-causing two mosquitoes will lead to dengue fever. So this, like I said, there are two primary mosquitoes, Aedes aegypti and Aedes albopictus, while the albopictus prefers living in bushes, shrubs and long grass, close to people, in a more rural environment. The Aedes mosquitoes are infected by dengue virus, and when they bite a dengue-infected person, in 8 to 12 days, the mosquitoes are able to transmit the dengue virus to another uninfected person. So that person will start to have symptoms within 5 to 7 days after being bitten by the infected mosquitoes. Another interesting factor, Madam Speaker, which is more effective dengue aegypti, which is more effective dengue transmitter to mosquito species, prefers feeding just before the sun rises in the morning, very interesting, and just before the sun goes down in the evening, so dawn and dusk. Like I've said, there are 26 species, 24 of them are nuisance, Madam Speaker. Dengue fever is also identified as one of the four climate-sensitive diseases in Fiji. Again, the clinical spectrum of dengue fever ranges from not having any symptoms to the symptomatic clinical cases and to the most severe ones that needs hospital admission, and the fatal ones at the very end of the scale normally die. Madam Speaker, any outbreak, whether it's a dengue outbreak, it's a bird flu outbreak in New Zealand, puts pressure on any health facility. And again, if I may go back to the Hansard report of Monday, 5th March, allow me to quote, Madam Speaker, then we are talking about including health. You go to hospitals, in the Lambasa hospital, when people come in the morning, they will go back home at 3 or 4 p.m. or 5 p.m., not sure what's the time limit. In the night, when they come at about 6 to 10 p.m., there are one or two doctors and they will continue to have problems sitting there by all those things. Madam Speaker, allow me to just present some waiting times with other, obviously, hospitals. Though we have experienced an increase because of dengue outbreak in the number of cases presented at our emergency department in all the hospitals and our general outpatients department, Madam Speaker, I can assure the House that our target for waiting time for patients to be seen in our emergency department is maximum 4 hours, depending on the severity of the case, some even below. Madam Speaker, this is the same as Australia and United Kingdom, and less than the New Zealand Hospital Emergency Department, which targets 95% of their patients treated or discharged within 6 hours. And we are talking about emergency department, Madam Speaker. Many of our dengue patients report to outpatients department, general outpatients department, where the waiting time is much less. So, Madam Speaker, on that, like I said, if I may reiterate, the only solution or the major solution to avoiding bit by dengue mosquitoes is to destroy all breeding places. Thank you.